Alright, so this is going to be a story about Tolkien, the dog. I just walked through the people's fair. It's way too loud and stuff going on to tell a story. So that's where the Capitol building we were just at. Right now, right here is the U.S. Mint. And I think what we'll do is we'll just walk towards Coors Field. And I'll try to tell the story of Tolkien and his whereabouts right now. First of all, he's no longer with me. Maybe I'll tell a Cliff Notes version. Then if you want to hear the full story, you can continue watching. But I could probably fill about 3 or 4 videos in that. So the Cliff Notes version is that he is now living with my parents in California. And he's doing really well. My folks came and picked him up from where I used to live, which I actually never showed you guys really that much. I was all the, some of the random DJ videos and stuff were in there. But anyways, he is now living with my folks in California with, I believe, 5 other dogs. And he lives on a 49-acre ranch, which is excellent because he wasn't getting the life that he needed anymore where he was at with me in Denver. So if that's all you're curious about, where's Tolkien, and if there will be any more dog videos, the answer is he's in California, and no, there will not be any more Tolkien videos, at least unless I visit him. So if that's all you're curious about, you can go ahead and continue your YouTube browsing experience elsewhere. If you are curious as to the full story, I will do my best right now to spit that out. Okay, walk here. The best that I can and as short, I suppose, as I can. So I guess what we'll do is we'll cover why he was not getting the life that he needed, which ultimately presented me with the decision to give him back to my folks.
Was he living down here?
No, he was just coming out of
here. Yeah, I consciously chose to give him back to my parents because he wasn't eating very well anymore, and he wasn't getting the attention that a big dog needs. And the reason why that was is that my girlfriend, who is now my ex-girlfriend, we were living together. We were dating for about two years, and the relationship ended unfavorably. And I asked her to leave my house, and so it was just Tolkien and I, and he was just kind of bummed out. And where the hell am I? Guess I'll walk this way. I don't know, kind of lost, but that's okay, it's fun. So yeah, she wasn't living with me anymore, so Tolkien was at home all day alone until I got home from work. So I'd leave at work at, 8 in the morning, and I wouldn't return till 6-7 at night. And then I had evening activities down at like the club and stuff, and doing other work that I'd have to leave the house again. And it absolutely just, it was just so hard to leave him like at home, and the look he would give me and everything. So I guess you might be wondering, well, how did it work before? Because you still had to go to work and everything, right? Well, my girlfriend didn't have a job anymore. Really wasn't doing anything with her life at all. Just kind of sat at home, which worked for that situation because she could be there. And she had a dog too. So Tolkien had a buddy and everything was cool. How long am I into this video? 5 minutes, alright, I can keep going. I guess so we'll walk this way. So I guess getting into that whole story, if you care to hear it. Let's see, where do I start? I'm gonna leave names out because I don't think that's a very respectful thing to do, to sludge anyone's name through the mud here, so we'll just refer to her as girlfriend, ex, whatever. And then we'll say just guy. So this guy, I'll be referring to this particular gentleman in the story, if you want to call him that. So we'd been together for about 2 years, living together for about one. And just like any relationship, there's ups and downs. And we had our fair share. And we were working on, you know, figuring out how to make the relationship work. We both, you know, loved each other a lot and stuff, but, you know, there were some core issues that we were having. Mine being, I guess what I expected out of her was to do something with her life. She had made a lot of very poor decisions over the last, like, year, and she was in debt. And she had collection agencies after her, and I'm gonna get hit. Oops. I guess when I say we, I kind of was the motivator in this decision, but I told her she needed to quit her job because it was driving her insane. That's actually where we met, was at this particular place I was working, and her boss was the fucking devil. She would come home just pissed off, angry, upset, depressed, whatever, and it was really fucking up our relationship. And I said, you know, hey, maybe you should quit your job because you're so fucking miserable there, and let's find something else for you. And I work a really well-paying job and everything, so I paid rent. I think she paid her half of rent for a month. That was it, the first month we moved in. So other than that, I paid rent, I paid bills, you know, put food on the table, all that kind of stuff. And that was okay with me. I was like, I'll continue to do that if you... like work on fixing up your life. She never finished school. Her mom pulled her out of school when she was like 16 or something to become a model. So she's never graduated high school. So I was kind of like, you know what? I'll pay for everything. And you get back in school. Let's get you something like that you can call a career, you know, and I'll support us financially during this whole time, and you know, you can get your stuff together. She had to give up her car because she couldn't make the payments because she got too expensive of a car to begin with, which was a poor decision. She skipped out on, oh, we're at the bar again, cool. She skipped out on her last month rent and apartment, so she owed them like $4,000. Because they charge you for like a month, and then a cancellation month, and then they charge you another month. It's just, you don't want to leave an apartment early. So yeah, wages are being garnished, da-da-da-da. So, I was always constantly kind of giving her another chance. You know, one chance has turned into three, into five, and then she'd come up with these grand schemes of like, oh, I'm going to do this job, or I'm going to do that job now, and this is going to work, and they always fell through, and I just kind of like was like, all right, see, we're at about 10 minutes, let me continue this story. If you're interested in this story, because it gets good after here, I'm just sort of setting up the stage right now, it'll be continued on the next bit, so, see there.